Hello and welcome back. In the previous lecture, we have seen what is engineering drawing and it's important. Here in this lecture, we are going to see the instruments required for completing the drawings. This is very important. Students are requested to be with the following instruments from next lecture onwards, because as this is a drafting course, you should and must draw the diagrams along with me. So you should have pencils 2H, H and HB. 2H is very lighter, H is somewhat darker than 2H, and HB is the darkest pencil which we will use in this course. So as you can observe here also, 2H pencil I have given in very light shade color, and you should have eraser of non-dust quality. You should purchase an eraser which is non-dust. You should have sharpener, drawing board, white sheets and clips, mini drafter and calculator. Here calculator is also important in engineering drawing, and compass, protractor. These all instruments are required. So first we will see about pencils. In pencils you should have 2H, H and HB marked pencils. 2H pencil is a lighter pencil and H pencil is somewhat darker than that, and HB is the darkest one. H pencil is actually in between H and HB. This grade indicates the lightness or darkness. So you see that I have used HB pencil there. This is our H pencil. And this is going to be aligned with 2H pencil. I am showing this just so that you can make a contrast between these three pencils, HB, H and 2H. There are other pencils also like 3H, 4H which will be very lighter than 2H also, but for this course we will use only H and 2H pencil, in very rare cases HB. So as I have said, in this course we will use H pencil to highlight outline features, the main important diagrams which are part of the solution. So the other extra lines and construction lines will be drawn with 2H pencil. So this is very important, H and 2H pencil. You should also have eraser of non-dust quality, because non-dust quality erasers do not leave dust marks after erasing lines. That is why you should have non-dust erasers only, and sharpeners. It should be of also good quality. I am talking about eraser and sharpener here because I have seen many students struggle to use eraser and sharpener also during the exam hall because of exam pressure. So you should have a good quality eraser and sharpener so that you will not face any problem because of this small things during the exam or while practicing engineering drawing. So here we will see now about a drawing board, clip and mini drafter. These are also very important. This is actually the important part when we are talking about manual drafting. So in manual drafting we should have a board on which we can place our drawing sheet, and clips so that we can attach that sheet on the drawing board, and mini drafter to draw straight lines which are 90 degrees to each other or orthogonal. So we will see how our drawing board will look. So this is the drawing board and the drawing sheet here with the clips, as you can see on your screen. The drawing board is essentially made of wood, that would be great, and this sheet is exactly getting adjusted or suited with the board. I have taken this purchase this board because this is suitable for my drawing sheet of the size, and drawing sheet will have different sizes, but in our college from where I did graduation, this was the sheet provided. Hence I suggest you to purchase the drawing board in accordance with the drawing sheet followed by your professor or in your college. You can observe the title bar here on which the name of college and your roll number and other particulars are written. In practicals also, like if you go to site, you will have this title bar. This is very important. Now, this is the drafter. As you can see here, the drafter will have two screws. One to adjust the scales. This is the screw to adjust the scales. Now you can see here. And this screw is for adjusting the drafter on the drawing board. You see that I will attach the drafter on the left hand side corner of the drawing board. Now this is fixed. Make sure it is fixed and it will not wobble. And I have just unscrewed the scale, and now you can see that I can cover whole portion of the sheet with my drafter. This is very important. And you can align the drafter scale with the straight line on the drawing sheet so that you will have no errors while drawing the lines. Now the drafter is aligned. I will draw one box here just to show you its usage of 10 by 10, 10 centimeter by 10 centimeter, or you can say 100 mm by 100 mm. So you see that I am easily drawing a box with the drafter, and I have completed this in very less time. You might think that with the scale also, with the steel ruler or other scales, we can do this. Yes, we can draw the box, but it will get difficult. And the drafters will have protractor scale also, as you can see here. And you can mark angles with this protractor scale. And you can see one mark will be there in the here where I am showing you the pencil. Here there will be a mark which is actually not visible from, I think, to you. But in your drafters you can find that mark that is given to take the angles. Angles like 30, 45 or any other angle between 0 to 90. So drafter is a multi-use instrument. You can draw straight lines, parallel lines, you can mark angles. And to show you why drafter is important, I will draw one more box of 10 centimeter by 10 centimeter. Now this is the ruler, not steel ruler, but I am having this scale. So I will draw again the same box of 10 by 10. You can say that as a square. I will try to draw it straight as much as possible. Now with this line, I have completed the square box. But you see that there will be a lots of difference between the accuracy of this box and this box. When I place the drafter here, you can observe that you are having some errors between these two lines. That means these two lines are not 90 degrees to each other, because these two drafter scales will be at 90 degrees to each other. So that is the error I have got by drawing with the scale. The error I might have avoided if I would have drawn this with the drafter scale. As you can see on this square box, there is no error. There is minimal error, you can say. That is why drafter is important. Here you are having a compass. Compass is used for drawing circles and arcs of different radius and diameters. Especially circles. So we will see about circles and arcs in the next lecture, that is basic shapes. But here you can just observe the usage of the compass. I'll just show you. The compass will have this screw so that we can fix the pencil inside. And you see that, and you have to make sure that that pencil and the nib should be aligned. They should touch each other. Now I have fixed it. And I have made sure that the nib and the pencil nib is at together. I'll just mark one point and I will try to draw one circle here. Try to hold the compass at the provision provided at the top. As you can see, I am holding it. so that it will not shake or wobble while drawing. Many students struggle while drawing with the compass. And now I am drawing some axis lines here, which is very important. Now I will show you about axis lines in circles in the next lecture, don't worry. But here you can observe a circle which has been formed with compass, and I will draw one arc also, just of any length, say this much length I am taking, 40 or 50 around. So now you can see an arc which has been formed here. Arc is nothing but incomplete circle. That's it. You see that I am measuring some radius 20 mm and I will draw one more circle here. You can measure the radius and diameter with this compass itself. Just you need to place it on the drawings, and you can place that after on the scale as I have shown. So this is going to be our protractor scale. This is used for marking angles. Actually, we have a protractor scale in drafter itself. Even then, I am showing you about protractor, because many protractors will come with errors, and this protractor will come very handy in that scenarios. So the protractor will have angles marked. Now I'll just draw one line by taking an angle of say 30 degree first. Observe here carefully. I have placed the point, center point, at the dot from where I have to take the angle. This is the center point, and I am taking the angle from this point. So if I point it at 30 degree, you see that 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 45, 60, 70, up to 180, and from here also. So I will mark at 30. Now from that center point, I will join this point, and this line is going to be our 30 degree with that baseline which was earlier there. That is our reference line. Now I will mark 60 degree angle also. You can see the difference between a 30 degree line and 60 degree line. And if I draw a straight line, this is going to be a 90 degree. This is going to be at 90 degree. So you can observe 30 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree lines drawn with our protractor scale. So I am giving some dimensioning here. We will see about dimensioning in the fourth lecture of this section. You can see with the drafter also, as I have shown you earlier, that there will be some mark. If I turn this drafter from the reference line, you will see that line, that mark portion will get aligned with the 30 degree on the protractor scale of the drafter. So drafter can be used for marking angles also. But I prefer using a compass scale only. You can see that now the mark is at 60 degree, and so sometimes it may get misplaced. That is why I prefer using protractor scale. And this is the 90 degree, as we can already know that these two scales are 90 degree to each other. I'll mark 90 degree there.